She is the colourful and sometimes controversial triple threat, a singer, comedian and radio host, and the airwaves of Sydney will have a little less glitter when she hangs up her headphones on Friday. Please welcome from Today FM Breakfast, the fabulous M. Rusciano.
Oh,
I know.
Make yourself comfortable.
Oh.
Hi, honey.
Bish. Bish has been on our show weekly now. It's the highlight of my week.
Oh, you say the nicest things. You wrote me a jingle. That's what got me coming back. And you sang it.
Yeah. I did. Of course I did. No one else gets a chance, you know.
Wow, you've had a really... eventful few weeks. You announced your pregnancy, which I cried when I read the news. Listened to the Will Anderson podcast, and when you lost your little boy, that was so hard on you. So to see you happy just made me sob.
Thank you.
And then you dropped another bombshell. You're done in breakfast radio
for this one
at least.
Yeah. No, I'm not going back. Do we have that on record? I'm not going back. To breakfast radio at all. I'm just not built for that kind of lifestyle. And I don't want my kids to look back and always remember me as grumpy and tired. Like, come 4 o'clock, I'm just a zombie.
Yeah.
So I think I wanted to enjoy the rest of my pregnancy. The last time I was pregnant, I was on breakfast radio and I worked the day I gave birth.
Wow.
When was this?
This was in Perth. So this was nearly 12 years ago, Scotty. And I literally left the studio and went to the hospital. So it was just not great. I was back 4 weeks after I gave birth.
So what
did you feel? Did you feel pressure to be back 4 weeks?
I did because I was the sole income earner and there was no maternity leave, and we need money. So I did. I went straight back.
And how long have you been doing breakfast radio for this time?
A year and a half, Scotty.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's a long time with those hours.
So it is.
What did you find the most challenging part of breakfast radio? Was it
That and not swearing not being too opinionated and, you know, all the things you have to appeal to everyone. And as we know, as you said, I am polarising. So I think just making myself be palatable for the general public was tough.
No, it's not palatable. And I loved that you said this on the podcast as well, that your whole life you've been this big person with big energy and big ideas, and you have constantly been told that you need to be smaller and take up less space and less room. And
which sometimes is a fair comment about me. Sometimes I'm just too much and the shushing is required. I understand that. I've got more self-aware as I've gotten older.
Yeah.
But I have... The reason I went out and did stand-up... I ran into Scotty at a dog park once and she said to me, I took up stand-up at your age and there's no reason why you shouldn't. So...
Did I?
Yeah, you did. Denise is the reason I went into stand-up all those years ago, and I got on a stage in a leotard and I was swearing and my dad was there and there were feathers and there were jokes and high kicks and dances.
Are you sure it was a stand-up gig?
Yes, I was. You know what I'm like. So I realised that I felt alive, and I love radio as a medium. I think it's brilliant, but you do have to fit everything into a three-minute block and you have to appeal to a lot of people and you can't swear. And I think I am a bit much for that small space.
When people haul you over the coals for stuff you've said, how do you react? How do you feel?
I'm pretty rock steady on the things that I believe in and who I am, and I've never set out to hurt people, and I never certainly personally attack anyone. So I'm very aware that my opinions aren't necessarily right. I'm not so in love with my opinions that I think they're right. They're just my opinions and I'm paid to have them. And if I wasn't paid to have them, I probably wouldn't put them out there, let's be real. But, I'm okay. I know who I am. I know who I am as a person and what I stand for, and I've got great family and friends, and I have been at the rock bottom. I've been in the fetal position at 2 a.m. crying into towels. So really anything the Daily Mail can write about me, and I've written everything.
You had some very choice words to say about that.
I don't know what you're talking about. What you mean? What I referred to the entire press as? Surprise, they came after me. I'm as shocked as you are.
Em, you made a point of stressing on Monday that leaving the show was your decision.
Absolutely, my decision.
How long did it take you to come to that decision? Because that's a great gig.
Yeah.
Life is about balance, but it's also finding your gladness. And
yes.
I like listening to you saying that you felt contained.
Yes.
And you have to be who you are and authentic, and it has to be right. And I think especially when you're pregnant, it puts life in perspective, doesn't it?
It does, especially because of the last pregnancy, I lost the baby. And it's another little boy too, which is so precious. And I've got two girls. I'm not quite sure what to do with a boy. Someone said to make sure you point it down. but I think my job is the top of the tree, the breakfast, broadcasting Sydney breakfast, and another woman deserves to be in there who that's her everything and that's what she's always wanted to do. And I respect my team so much and my co-hosts, and my heart just wasn't in it anymore. I wanted to focus on the pregnancy. I want to do stand-up. I want to write female erotica. And
do you?
Yeah,
really?
I'm doing that.
Here's my pen.
It's a finger.
It's a finger.
We all made that mistake.
Jeez, I knew it was a finger. How dare you? Yeah, no, I'm writing fiction for HarperCollins, so that's going to be with my name, not a pen name.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do that, and there's so many other things I want to do, and my job deserves all the love and attention it can be given. So
And three kids.
Yeah. And three dogs and a husband. And so, yeah, it's time. It's time for me to step out of that seat and vacate it for a woman who truly wants to be there and loves it.
There's new adventure.
Yeah.
There's a real vulnerability when you're pregnant, I think. Well, that I felt the same way.
See, I feel tougher than ever.
Well, I find it sort of a kind of a duplicitous thing. On one hand, you feel so very vulnerable, but on the other hand, you're almost like this tiger mother.
You should see me in traffic.
Rip the throats out to protect your baby. Yes. And it does put things into sharp focus. Did you have a family meeting before you decided to quit?
I don't know how family meetings go at your house, but at my house, everyone sits down and I tell them what's going to happen.
Right.
So we're
happy to have you back.
Yes. My husband especially. Everyone's glad. I mean, this job has afforded me amazing things. I've been able to fund my own tours and do my own thing. And, you know, it's been great. I don't regret anything. But the decision was made. As soon as I found out I was pregnant, I knew I would finish up at the end of this year. And then I'm now kind of halfway and I'm just struggling to get up at 4 a.m. I'm really struggling. It's hard.
It's not a bad thing. Congratulations for all you've done. This isn't like a big deal. Radio is just one medium, and honestly, on some levels, it's really pedestrian. And so you've got so many other things you're going to be doing.
Yes.
It's like a Saturn V rocket jet to sing the bit you don't need.
Well, I'm like a peacock in a cage. I've been referred to that a lot by my bosses. But I'm so grateful to Today FM, and I hope to be allowed on there to haul my various wares. And well, can I say that on stage?
The only thing I felt, you know, one of the great things I've always found about being, when you go into a show that's low rating, is that no one cares, no one notices, and you've got time and space to work it up. Mm. I was always annoyed for you. You didn't care. I was always annoyed for you that you never seemed to have clean air. To me, you just didn't. You never got a chance. Were you surprised by the amount of scrutiny on a show that you went into that was low rating? It's not your fault.
Unbelievable.
2 days got issues.
Yeah, I mean, it's unbelievable the amount of scrutiny in Sydney that's on Today FM. It is just ridiculous. And there are some amazing hard. My production team are incredible people. A lot of new blood through, but it doesn't matter. They write the same old things.
Yep.
And I don't think the ratings reflect the quality of our show. And now I can say this because I'm leaving and I'm not going to get in trouble. The rating system is ridiculous.
It certainly is.
And it's
just tell everyone at home, because I don't think people realise how the rating systems
work. Tell people how the rating systems work. I've still got two more shows, Sassy.
Oh, okay. I'll do it. So essentially, it's a form. It's a paper diary that you fill out with a pencil.
Yeah.
How does that even work in 2018?
But guess who's number one every week on the Instagram statistics? We are. We are the most engaged show. We are the most liked show. And that doesn't come through. And our podcast rate's higher than everyone else's. And so all the feedback we're getting from new media is that people love us. Mm. But the ratings book is what we all live and die by. And I know people will say, if you're on top, you'd be loving that system. Yeah, well,
totally
we're not, so I'm going to come back.
The reality, too, of the rating system is that it would catch up. Like, all of the things that you're talking about would have an impact. But this is my thing about clean air. Normally, when you're on a low-rating show, they focus on the top raters and you've just got your own space to develop
We've
your
had
show
none.
Up. And I've really felt for you and the guys that you just haven't had your own space to just create your thing, and it would have caught up, because you're right, it's an archaic system and it'll catch up with Instagram and those things.
Mm. I won't miss that.
That's the way that goes.
Yeah, I just will not miss every single thing being scrutinised. You know, at the end of the day, guys, it's just breakfast radio.
Oh, my God, it's so just breakfast radio.
It's just people getting in the car, going to their jobs, and we'll tell fart jokes and you'll hear us for 6 minutes and then you'll forget. And that's it. But the way, the bubble you're in there and the pressure you're under and the ratings and the second guessing what everyone wants to hear, you end up, I'm a crazy person and I'm looking forward to kind of stepping outside of the breakfast radio bubble and filling my lungs with clean air and remembering that it doesn't define me and it doesn't define my... your self-esteem takes such a hit when the ratings come in. You're like, well, why am I even getting up today? Is anyone listening?
It was always, to me, like that 13th birthday party and no one comes. Oh, yeah. You know,
yeah, I've
I'm
put
there
on everything.
With my party hat on. Yeah. We've got the smorgasbord in the garage.
Yeah.
No one's there.
We killed a guinea pig at my 13th, so...
Wow.
Unintentionally, it was horrible, but they're very sensitive. I learned that.
Your beautiful baby is due...
February. End of January. I'm very excited. I've already put on the allowed amount of weight, so I'm already overachieving.
it's so hard. You're
I'm
so
eating
hungry
so
all
much.
The time, especially with boys. We wish
Is that
you...
a thing? Oh. You eat more with boys?
I was 100 kilos the day I gave birth.
Yes, me too last
yeah,
time.
Yeah.
All right. Yes.
Now, Em, your Thanks. Final broadcast, your final Down Today FM breakfast is on Friday. We
yes.
wish you so much love
Thank
and
you.
Good vibes for this beautiful Thank pregnancy you. And this beautiful little boy that
Thanks
you're
Thanks for having me.
Em Rusciano, everyone.